Awesome everyone, so welcome back to my channel and today we are doing an interview question. I hope you're all well. Before we get into the video, I hope you're all doing okay. Very quickly, just to say a huge thank you from me to you guys for all the love on my recent videos. It's been wonderful seeing you guys subscribe and like, and it's been really helpful for me as well because, you know, I'm able to put out more videos like this and it's been a lot more helpful, hopefully, for you guys. So just take literally a couple of seconds out of your day, just now, if you don't mind just scrolling down or, you know, whatever, and just smashing that subscribe button down below. It would mean the world to me. It'd be really helpful for me as well to, you know, get an understanding of how many of you are subscribing and, you know, which videos put out. And also smash the like button. So literally just now, I'll give you like 5 seconds, just go and smash that subscribe button down below. Awesome. So I'm assuming by this point you've subscribed and let's get into the video. So today we're going to be doing an interview question video and we are talking all about a particular question that comes up every year and is quite a bittersweet question because some people find it super challenging, some people find it super easy. So what do you do in this scenario? And the question is, why medicine? And it's often the question that you get asked a lot. You know, if you go to a friend's house or if you're visiting relatives and you say that you're planning on applying to medicine, they usually ask you why medicine. And it's not an easy question to answer because there are a lot of things to get right with this answer, especially in an interview format, and it's very easy to get it wrong and give a really bad answer. So you do need to do some things in the answer, and today we're going to be going over that very briefly in 5 or 6 quick tips to help you smash that answer. Bring in work experience. If you're failing to come up with an answer that lacks any sort of personal anecdotes or lacks any sort of personal experience, bring in work experience. What universities will be more than happy and often what they want to see is that you are quite open-minded, you know, for some part of your life. And having done work experience at a variety of different places, that's the environment you're going to be working in when you're older, if you become a doctor or a GP. And if that's the environment you decided to become a doctor, it means that you know you're going to succeed in that environment. You know you're going to do well there. So they really like hearing you talk about your work experience and, you know, bringing that into your answer. So I would highly recommend doing that, just for a little bit, even for just one line. But that's a really good thing to do. Don't be a robot. The worst thing you can do in an interview is to come out with an answer that's clearly been rehearsed and it's been scripted and it's been repeated as many times as Romeo and Juliet. Because the problem with it is that they don't believe your answer and they're probably right. It's probably a fake answer that you made up. If you're talking on the spot, off the cuff, they're more likely to believe you. And not only believe you, they're more likely to like your answer because they think that you're genuinely telling them why you want to be a doctor. So I would highly recommend doing that. Now, it's obviously quite tricky to not be robotic. Obviously, you're going to be nervous, but I would really recommend you guys to just take a minute, breathe before you give the answer, and just talk. Just talk from your heart. I know it's really cringe and it's cheesy, but I can't phrase any way better. Just genuinely talk and don't be so robotic or scripted when you're talking because it can really have a negative effect on the marks you get during the MI. Bring in personal examples. Some of you guys who are listening to this video, watching this video, might have personal anecdotes that you have an idea of for your answer, and that's fantastic. There's nothing wrong against it. Some people say that, you know, don't bring in those things, you know, it gets too emotional, but there's nothing wrong with it. I brought it in my interview, nothing was wrong with it. I think those people are just sort of getting over the top with the advice. You just need to have an answer that's good and solid, and if you have a personal experience, it can be even better. It shows that you've gone through a significant part of your life where it shows, you know, set you on the right path. And if you want to bring it in, yes, make it the foundation of your answer, but don't spend the whole time talking about it. Just say that this happened to me, or I went through this, and it's made me realise. And explain to them why it's made you realise you want to be a doctor. Was it the pain you went through and the urge to, you know, stop other people feeling the same pain? Or was it the doctors and nurses and consultants that you saw every day in the hospital? Anything, whatever reason it is, give that reason. Don't just give the experience and then say, so I want to be a doctor. Explain why the experience makes you want to be a doctor, because that's what they want to find out. And they don't really want to hear much about your experience. It's not really that interesting to them. Sorry to let you know. What they want to know is why you want to be a doctor. And that why word is really important. Beware of the blurred line between medicine and science. The worst thing you can do is have an answer that is full of reasons why you want to be a doctor, because you were so good at science from a young age, you enjoyed biology, GCSE biology, and that's it. That's the only reason you become a doctor. You say that, your interviewer is going to stop the interview and give you directions to the biomedical building. Because realistically, that kind of answer belongs in that building. You're in a medical building, you're doing a medical interview, you need to stick to the emotions and the empathy. That's what makes medicine unique. It combines science and emotions. So there's nothing wrong with talking about GCSE biology or A-level chemistry or A-level biology. You know, that's perfectly fine. That's, or human biology, whatever you've taken. That's perfectly fine. What I would say is to make sure you bring some sort of emotion into your answer. To say, I want to combine this with, you know, a job that gives me the reward or the freedom to be empathetic with people and meet new people every day. Those skills that make being a doctor very unique. Avoid cliches. Now, this is probably the biggest thing with this answer, because if you say, I want to be a doctor because I want to help people, they will kick you to the north coast of Scotland. That is the worst answer and the most frustrating answer you could ever hear, because it's so cliched. Everyone said it, everyone's heard it, and it's literally got no substance to it. It's the equivalent of eating a Sainsbury brand cereal for breakfast as opposed to Weetabix. It's got no nutrition in it, it's virtually cardboard, and it's nothing. So please don't just say you want to help people. Avoid cliches like, I want to be a doctor because my dad's a doctor or my mum's a doctor. That might be true, but build on it. Don't just say that. Say, okay, my parents are a doctor and I've seen how much work he has to do and the reward he gets. I remember seeing him do work, whether it was in a GP clinic or over the phone, and I've been really interested in it ever since, seeing how much work he has to do, and I think it'd be a really cool thing for me to do in the future as well. And I've done research into it since, I've done work experiences, and that kind of thing, giving material and giving provable experience that you've done things to be a doctor, is what's going to make your answer stand out. And they know that not everyone's going to give them a unique answer, because a lot of people are going to have similar answers. But as long as it's a good, strong, solid answer with evidence and it's not widely cliched, they're going to be more than happy. This question is usually an icebreaker anyway, so it won't have too much impact on your interview, but it's nevertheless, it is important to not start off on a stinker. That's all I'd say. Summary, stay honest with the reason, don't make it up, and make it special to yourself. Make sure they remember you for who you are in the interview, don't be someone else. So yeah, that's everything I can remember. If you've got any questions about this video, any questions about, you know, the interview in particular, drop them in the comments below, smash the like button. And again, please do go and subscribe, it'd be so helpful for me. It'd be really cool if you guys could just go and smash that down below. Yeah, that's everything. Thank you very much for watching. I'll see you in the next video. Peace.